Sensor Captain Kells said it's going to take a lot of hard work and discipline if I want to be as good as you. Everyone isn't out to eradicate these abominations.
Got it.
I've been told the Valentine Detective Agency signs are an eyesore. But they sure bring in the business.
Now you're
all yours, sir. Can't wait till we start live weapons training. Someday, I want to be the best laser rifle.
Thank you.
wish they'd let me have a gun. Proctor Teagan just laughed at me. Today, it's going to be hard to go back to patrolling the Pridwin.
Thank you.
looks really strong.
Guts.
lights out for you.
Other squires are going to be so jealous when I get back. It's not every day they let us squires out into the field. Someday, I want to be the best laser rifle shooter in the Brotherhood.
Yes, I'm the detective.
Thank goodness. Let me just open the door for you. Residents, and they are very worried.
What happened? Who died?
It's Mr. Parker, the primary owner and financier for the hotel. This is just a disaster.
Well, well. This place just got a little more interesting.
Realize that they're going to disturb the evidence. You'd better come with me, Detective.
dairy snacking.
Please, if I may.
That's what
this is
to
you. I could just have your attention.
You're sick.
I'm sorry for shouting. But the detective has arrived and shall begin the investigation henceforth. Please return to your rooms until the detective has examined the crime scene and had a chance to come speak with you.
It's not every day they let us
have a look at the crime scene for clues. When you're ready, we can discuss your findings. You are free to question the residents, but their safety is our priority. So unless you have solid evidence, I would avoid accusations.
Soon I'll graduate tonight and get to take on missions like this on my own.
Is this blood? Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed.
After this, I can't wait till we start live weapons training.
Perfect. Baseball bat. What is this doing here? Red paint?
I found the murder weapon.
Oh no. That's the bat from Mr. McKinney's movie. You don't think he could be involved, do you? I can't imagine him ever doing such a thing. Was there anything else?
That's not blood around the body. It's red paint.
Mr. Santiago would definitely have red paint. But surely he wouldn't have... Would he? This is just terrible, Detective. Was there anything else?
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner and financier for the hotel. He had vast experience managing venture projects around the world. It was his idea to have our premier clients become investors in the vault section of the hotel. He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
Your residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway. I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robotic chassis. Was there anything else?
I'm not sure where I should start.
I suppose you should try to figure out how he died, and then who had the means and motive to kill him. Once you have enough evidence, then I suppose you'll need to confront the killer. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here, should you need me.
You're gonna tell me that's nothing?
It wasn't like that. We were friends. He helped me out of a tight spot or two is all.
I couldn't stand by like some pasty-faced Percy while he put the moves on my best girl.
But now the law is on our tail. What are we going to do?
Come away with me. Let's leave this dark hole of a city behind. We can be in Buenos Aires by tomorrow.
Oh, I want to believe you, I do, but you'll never let us go.
Then we'll make our stand here. I've got a gun for each of us.
Said it's going to take a lot of hard work, and I want to be as good as you.
Squire.
I can't believe I was lucky enough to get this assignment.
God. Why can't I ever get that line? Forget it. I can't do this right now.
Fine. I'm going to the beach.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have a questions about the case.
I found your baseball bat at the crime scene. Care to explain how it got there?
Someone is clearly trying to frame me for the murder. It's probably Santiago. You saw him skulking around the crime scene.
What were you and Gilda talking about when I walked in?
Hmm? Oh, we were just rehearsing a scene. Nothing to worry about.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
It's obviously Santiago. He keeps going back to look at the crime scene.
Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
I wish they'd let me have a gun. Tegan just laughed at me. After today, it's going to be hard to go back to the home of Franklin.
Nobody, I guess.
Hey.
You all right? You need something?
Your thoughts?
Nice to feel like we're really making a difference out here.
Your thoughts?
You'd be shocked how many folks I've managed to convince I'm just a really sick ghoul.
That's all.
Got it.
Protect and serve.
Art is life. Without it, we are no different than animals.
Yeah, if all we are is a sentient floating in a suit of flesh, or metal, I suppose, then art is the only true communion with the world. Come with me. Tell me, what does this piece say to you?
It's about composition, the balance of colors and emotions, and the struggle to maintain internal order.
Indeed. This was the last piece I did in a series of portraits of Gilda. Number 1378. Her emotional landscape is superimposed on the portrait. The reality of the subject is distorted as the ego attempts to project itself. This way. What does this one say to you?
It looks like trees in space. Maybe it's about the struggle to maintain life adrift in an empty void?
Intriguing. What a post-cynical futurist interpretation. All meaning is contained in the struggle for life to continue. At one, not this one. And please be honest, for art without honesty is just politics.
It's cute, I guess. Some people like that kind of thing.
More than you would imagine. Truth be told, this is my best-selling piece. I did this series under a pseudonym, of course. This series has made more money than any of my serious works. And I did the whole thing as a lark. What the hell did you have to find your art to the common man? My fellow connoisseur of the art. Here to see my latest work.
I found red paint at the crime scene. No one knows about that.
No, actually. Ezra borrowed my last gun. Now I can't find it.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
The person you should be looking at is Juliana Riggs. That Philistine would not know art from her own excrement. She and Ezra had another little magic fight recently. You could hear her banshee screeches all the way across the hotel.
What were Juliana and Ezra arguing about?
I don't know. I was painting at the time and I was trying to block it out. Though I bet you're probably right there. Maybe you should check with her.
I think you could explain why you keep returning to the crime scene.
It's for inspiration, detective. The others do not like to think about it, but you shall die someday. Like Prometheus's torch, it kindles within me the fire to create as much art as I can with the time that I have.
Never mind.
My fellow connoisseur of the art, here to see my latest work.
It sounds like you've done a lot of paintings of Gilda. Why her?
Our Gilda is a very singular creature, detective. Anyone sees what they feel from within her. I have never met another who clings to life tenaciously, who lives in the moment. I must admit I was quite smitten with her for a time.
You're still in love with Gilda, aren't you?
So what if I am? What if this is yours? She deserves someone who truly understands her ephemeral beauty.
Never mind.
Hello, Mr. Whisk.
I'll graduate tonight.
Who's a pretty kissy?
Like this on my own.
Juliana, yeah, Mr. Whiskers died last month. This is Cluffy. Remember?
Oh. Of course. Silly me.
Just let me have a look at the neural interface matrix, and I'm sure I can clear that.
No. No, it's not that. I've just caught another cold. Probably something the Guardian when they sent Pearl out.
Not this again. Last month you were convinced you had the measles.
You're not a doctor. What would you even know about it? Besides, I think it may be malaria.
First of all, I am a doctor.
Yes, but not...
You sure made a mess of this place, didn't I?
Robotics is...
The other squires are going to be so jealous when I get back.
I've told you time and again, you can't get sick inside the suit. It's not physically possible.
I know when I'm getting sick, Bert. Now why don't you just wander off and play in your lab? Mr. Scruffy and I are going to rewrite the will. So he will get everything when I die because horrible Bert didn't believe me.
Oh, God, Juliana.
After this, I can't wait till we start live weapons training.
I heard that Juliana and Ezra had an argument a few days before he was found dead. Tell me about that.
Well, I was in my lab at the time, so I didn't hear it. But Juliana has always been rather critical of Mr. Parker. I think she found something in the overseer's office. I wasn't listening when she told me about it. I kind of had my head in my research. I don't know, really. I try to let her handle all the money stuff. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Oh, well, that's not really my field of expertise, but I'm sure there are probably some clues as to... Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Tell me about yourself.
Oh, well, I'm a scientist. You've probably met my wife, Juliana, already. Not sure what else to say, really. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Tell me about your research.
Well... I was one of the leads on the team that created the first robo-brains, the precursors to our model. Most people don't find it all that interesting, and I'd rather not bore you. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
I'd like to hear more about your research.
Oh, wonderful. No one else here really wants to talk about it. Fortunately, this model is more or less the same as the previous versions I worked on, but without the neural inhibitor and the reconditioning. The voice modulator seems to have some minor issues interfacing with the neural matrix, which can add some moodiness. But that's easily solved with regular tune-ups. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
I'd like to hear more about your research.
I'm afraid that's really all I should say about it. I mean, it is still classified, but I wanted to help with the investigation. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Robo-brains have a voice modulator. Tell me about that.
That's what allows us to recreate our original voices. They can mimic any normal human voice, actually. I've speculated for some time that the issues we had with our recruited subjects is due to the brain attempting to preserve a sense of self. Maintaining our original voices helps reinforce the neural network, sort of like playing music for an Alzheimer patient. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Never mind.
Very well, I'll just get back to my work then.
Hello, Detective. Did you have a question about the heinous murder?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
I heard you had a big fight with Ezra a few days ago. Care to explain?
Oh, well, it wasn't that big a deal, really. He wanted more money to pay for repairs on the hotel. I wasn't feeling well that day and lashed out a bit at the poor man. I really should have listened to him more.
What's with all the junk in here?
These are our things. We're just waiting till the war blows over so we can bring them back to the mansion.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm Juliana Riggs, heiress to the Riggs fortune and wife of Bert Riggs. I'm not sure what else you expected, Detective.
Never mind.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
Someday, I want to be the best laser rifle shooter in the Brotherhood.
Hello, Detective.
see why everyone isn't out to eradicate these abominations.
Anyone actually felt like they were the teacher in here?
They'd let me have a gun. Talked their teeth and just laughed at me. The other squires are going to be so jealous. Why everyone isn't out to eradicate these abominations. Someday, I want to be the best laser rifle shooter in the Brotherhood.
Progress on construction of the second wing of the vault is completely stalled. Once the premier area of the vault had been completed, funding seems to have been cut off. My supervisors informed me they haven't received payment from this department. The Vault Tech won't pay out of pocket to continue construction. I've repeatedly approached Ezra about the finances, but he keeps telling me that Mrs. Riggs has a transfer. However, listener, Juliana, said that she had just given Ezra extra for the gold payment. I've hired an investigator to look for signs of embezzlement.
Sounds like Ezra was embezzling from his investors. Never mind. I found some evidence that Ezra was embezzling from you and the other investors.
Oh, well, I really believe that. Mr. Parker wouldn't do such a thing, I'm sure.
Never mind.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
Is there anything else?
Have you noticed Juliana acting strangely lately?
Oh, well, I'm probably just being paranoid, but she's been so much more pleasant lately. I mean, it's been nice, but also a bit unnerving. Most people don't really understand us, but I always appreciated how she could just take charge of a situation. This would allow me to focus on my research. I feel that something has happened to her. She doesn't seem like the same person.
What do you mean Juliana's not the same person?
My wife has always been a very harsh woman, Detective. I don't know who it is, you know. That is not my wife, Detective. Was there something else, Detective?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
I found a love letter to Ezra in your room. Know anything about it?
I should have never written it. I just couldn't take it any longer.
Tell me about you and Ezra.
Oh God, I don't know. When we first met him, he was just so mysterious and exciting. It seemed like he had been everywhere and done everything. I convinced Gilda that we should invest in the hotel so I could stay close to him. But he never seemed to realize how I felt. I mean, we spent time together. Going hunting, having drinks, talking about his plans for the hotel. He must have known, but he never said anything. Do you have any idea what it's like to pine for someone for 200 years, Detective?
Tell me about yourself.
We went over this before, Detective. There's no motive.
Maybe you could give me a reason it couldn't be you.
I would never harm Ezra, Detective. I was in love with him.
Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
Someday, I want to be the best laser writer.
You're the real murderer.
That's just silly, Detective. Why would I want to kill Mr. Parker?
Maybe you could give me a reason it couldn't be you.
I'm sick all the time, Detective. I don't have the strength to do such a thing.
Give it up. I know your secret, Juliana. Or should I say, Ezra?
Well, Detective, that's quite the claim.
It's a shame. I thought I could keep the ruse going a little longer. Oh, well, had to end eventually, I suppose. This doesn't have to end in more violence, Detective. Just walk away. I'll leave, and you can tell them I escaped.
Why did you kill Juliana?
I hadn't planned on it, but Juliana figured out what I was doing and had to be dealt with swiftly. I thought I could get a bit more money out of this place before making my escape. What's it going to be, Detective? Join me in getting rich or die defending some outdated ideal?
Okay, I'll let you go.
Well, I'm glad you've decided to be reasonable. I would have hated for this to come to more bloodshed. All right, Detective. Tell Maxwell that it's over and get your reward. Then I'll make my way out when things have died down.
Hey, you got a second?
Of course, Nick. What's up?
I wouldn't normally bother you with this sort of thing, but, well, I know I can trust you at this point. For as long as I can remember, I've been getting these, flashes. Memories of places I've never been. Things I've never seen. Memories of Nick's. They're not bad. They're just this inescapable reminder that I'm not the person I think I am. That I'm not a person at all. I'm just a machine, pretending to be human.
You think, you feel. You're more than pretending, Nick.
Yeah, nice of you to say, but your kind don't usually have to deal with someone else's whole life trapped inside their skulls. Don't get me wrong. I know I'm in Nick's debt. These memories, they've kept me alive. Nick was a hell of a cop. Guy with good instincts and a good heart. I always counted myself lucky they didn't load me up with some ex-con or whatever type might volunteer to let folks tinker with their gray matter. But it's thanks to Nick that I pass for human. Why I get to live cushy in Diamond City and every other synth is shot on sight. I know I got it good, but my entire life I owe to Nick. Everything that makes me who I am, my judgment, my speech, hell, even my name, they're his. And I can't do a damn thing about it, because without them I'm nothing. A shell. All I want is a life where I have something I can call my own.
You've already built a life for yourself, Nick. You've got the agency, a home, friends.
Yeah, I mean, you're not wrong. You know, I'm just gonna need some time to think on this. I appreciate you hearing me out. You're a real good friend. Thanks. You know, there is this chunk of Nick Valentine history I've been hoping to put a bow on for a while now. I could use a hand if you're willing to take a crack at it. That's fine. Talk later.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
I found Ezra. He was the killer the whole time.
My word! I never thought Mr. Parker was capable of something like this. What happened when you confronted him?
He got away before I could catch him.
I can't say the residents will be pleased that you let him get away, but I suppose there's nothing to be done about it. At least it's over. There you are, Detective. Payment for your services and a bonus for uncovering such a heinous plot. I don't think we could have done it without you.
Graduate tonight and get to take on missions like this on my own. I wish they'd let me have a gun. after this, I can't wait till we start live weapons training. Lancer Captain Kell said it's going to take a lot of hard work and discipline if I want to be as good as you. Hard to go back to control.
Wanted one to waste.
other squires are going to be.
Another day in Far Harbor.
I need to talk to you about our missing synth.
Yeah? Well, it's not something I talk about with outsiders. You can either buy something or move along.
I'm working with Chase. She told me that your designation is L792.
Okay, I believe you. Keep it down, all right? It's real private information. I know the synth you're talking about. He's a younger guy, maybe early 20s, with white hair. Goes by the name Derek. Thing is, he showed up way earlier than he was supposed to. Thought a courser was on his tail, so he rushed the timetable. To be honest, the guy was a wreck. He was scared shitless, looking over his shoulder every 5 minutes and attracting unwanted attention. Tried to calm him down, but he panicked and ran off into the fog. That was the last I saw of him.
Can you tell me anything else? I'm gonna need more information than that if I'm gonna find this synth.
I wish I had more to give you. He disappeared into the fog, and I haven't seen him since.
That synth could be wandering around out there right now, lost in the fog. I'm gonna need more than that.
I've told you everything I know, all right? You think I wanted this to happen? Well, I didn't. Look, if you're really going after that synth, I'm pretty sure he took the road south out of town. Maybe you could head that way. Just be careful out there. And thanks. There aren't many who go out in the fog to help a synth. Especially one they don't even know. I feel like shit about what happened. I really do. I hope you can make it right.
The doctor has said in time, I will fully recover. He says this is your doing? I do not know you.
I was just doing my civic duty.
You are obviously not from here. Gratitude. It's a hard thing out here. So, yeah, this island. It has taken my husband. It has taken everything. This island is a sickness. Don't you see? It's evil. As soon as I am well, I am going to grab as many guns as I can carry, and I will slaughter everything in my path until the island is clean, or I am no more.
You're in pain. Yeah, I've been there. But your plan is unreasonable. Find a purpose, some constructive purpose. To keep you going.
You wouldn't know. Once, Far Harbor was, well, not thriving, but alive. I'll think on what you said.
I wish they'd let me have a gun. Proper teeth.
Ooh, stimpak.
Only opens with a key.
I don't see. is why everyone came out to eradicate this bomb. Lancer Captain Kells said it's going to take a lot of hard work if I want to be as good as you.
Some more, and soon. We heading out?
That's right. Let's get going.
After you, then.
You sure you two are gonna be all right out there?
Quit your worrying, Metal Man. We'll be fine.
I was lucky enough to get the assignment.
socks that don't have holes.
Today, it's going to be hard to go back to controlling the trickling. I'll graduate tonight and get to take on... like this on my own. Lancer Captain. Kells said it's going to take a lot of hard work and discipline if I want to be as good as you.
Open something.
You're dead!
Hide forever!
Thank you.
As you were.
reached something awful here.
Phew, that smell. Wish I had one of them pre-war breath masks. Smell that? Something must be rotten. Stinks to high heaven. Stinks to high heaven. Phew, that smell. Wish I had one of them pre-war brothers.
The other squires are going to be so jealous when I get back.
No way I could pick this. Bingo.
You were amazing out there, sir.
You handled yourself well. You honor the Brotherhood. Let's head back.
Sir!
You're back. Tell me, did the Squire do well?
Roger that.
Good job. Now, there is a more pressing matter we need to discuss. Virgil, as long as that abomination lives, he's a threat to the Brotherhood. The time has come to deal with him.
He helped us before. We can't just betray him.
We don't owe him anything. What he did for his own reasons. He served his purpose. Now he's just another monster. And a damn dangerous one.
A threat? One super mutant?
This Virgil once led the Institute's biomedical research. He experimented with FEV. He tested it on human subjects. How many super mutants did he create? How many lives have been lost because of his hubris? No. He and his work are a threat. They must be destroyed.
What's the plan?
Better to keep this simple. He trusts you. Go alone, and he may let his guard down. Get in, get the job done, and get out. That's all there is to it.
I'll take care of it, Captain.
Thank you, Sentinel. Dismissed.